My name is Huw Beynon, I'm Head of Studio Communications for Metro Last Light, and you're watching Platform 32.
I love immersive first-person shooters, especially if they have a scary twist. So, unsurprisingly, I was a massive fan of Metro 2033, even despite its slightly dodgy combat mechanics and occasional bad level design. The supernatural Eastern apocalyptic tale was incredibly atmospheric, and I enjoyed every moment in the Russian underground with Artyom and his Russian comrades. The sequel, Metro Last Light, was announced just before last year's E3 and was due for release at some point this year, but for whatever reason the usual delays have happened and the game will now not be available until 2013. Keen to keep people's interest in the game high, THQ recently held an event where they unveiled some brand new footage of the game, which you're watching right now, which concentrated on the more supernatural element of the game. I managed to grab a chat with Huw Beynon from THQ and asked him to tell us all about this sequel.
Metro Last Light is a direct narrative sequel to Metro 2033, based on the novel by Dmitry Glukhovsky. We've worked with Dmitry this time around to continue Artyom's story and thrust you back into the Metro. Dmitry wrote a follow-up to Metro 2033 called, surprisingly, Metro 2034, a very different style of book. He describes it as an art house novel. It wasn't really suitable for a video game adaptation, but we really wanted to explore Artyom's story. He's a very interesting protagonist. We kind of left him on almost a literal cliffhanger at the end of the first game, so we worked very closely with Dmitry to develop a new story arc for Artyom, and we've been working with him throughout the project. We keep a similar balance in gameplay styles in Metro Last Light. You'll find these station city environments where you can really explore the richness of the world, overhear conversations, see how society has actually evolved or devolved in the towns below Moscow, and that's where you'll trade your currency, buy new ammunition, buy new weapons or upgrade your weapons, and then the rest of the game is really spread between these very cinematic, maybe more scripted levels. That's where we really dial up the tension and the survival horror, and then perhaps more emergent freeform levels where you find combat with stealth mechanics, particularly against human opponents. So a lot of different gameplay styles.
Sounds excellent, although very similar to the layout of Metro 2033 in gameplay terms. As with all sequels, developers try to better the experience they delivered first time round. How have you guys improved on the Metro formula in Last Light to make Artyom's new adventure even more compelling?
We think we've got the basic formula of Metro 2033 right last time. It's a story-driven action-adventure, and we combine a lot of very different gameplay styles, from kind of classic first-person shooter combat to survival horror to exploration and even RPG elements. One of the real focuses for us this time around was to improve the combat experience. We spent a lot of work improving the AI, the way the weapons feel and handle, and that was something that we really demonstrated in our demo last year. What we showed you today kind of tapped into our survival horror inspirations a lot more, so this constant struggle for survival, and it also neatly showed off a few new mechanics. First of all, this mask mechanic whereby you have to wipe blood from your mask, debris that's blowing in on the wind. You saw him clutch a spider off his mask and then just wipe the goo away that it left. This is just something that you know, increases that immersion in the game world. And we also showcased some of our dramatic new weather effects. The rain came in, lightning, clouds rolling in. It's really made us bring these outdoor environments to life in a way we didn't really do with the first game.
All those little touches serve to create a very tense atmosphere in the demo, so God knows how it's going to make me feel when I'm sat on my own in the dark with my surround sound headphones on. All I can say is I hope the Metro Last Light Collector's Edition comes with a clean change of pants. Tell me, Huw, am I really going to be scared?
Yeah, the supernatural aspect of Metro Last Light is really, really important to us. And you saw some examples in the demo today. The Moscow Metro is awash with this psychic phenomena. Artyom has almost a unique talent, and although he's aware of it, he has a certain resilience to it. But hopefully you were suitably creeped out by the sequence inside the plane. That's before you got to the flashback. For any of the guests here today who are trying to fly back tonight, good luck to them.
Huw is right. That particular scene was very intense, especially as the action flashed back to the Russian pilots as the plane was crashing, and I'm sure playing that on your own would definitely be a very, very creepy and jump-filled experience. Which is exactly what I'm hoping for from this game. So, how long can we expect the game to be? Longer than 2033 or around the same length?
We think the single-player campaign is going to be at least as long as Metro 2033. We're also looking at how we can build a bit more replayability into it, although we know from our fans that lots of people replayed it multiple times. It certainly rewards more than one playthrough, and there are levels that can be approached in completely different ways. So we think there seems to be a trend amongst first-person shooters that campaigns are getting shorter. I think Metro 2033 was probably one of the longer single-player campaigns out there, so you know, we think Last Light will stack up really well in that regard. Of course, we're also adding a completely new multiplayer component to the game. It's not something that we showed today. We'll be revealing more of that later in the year, but it's a very significant portion of the game.
Now, single-player purists might be a bit worried about this addition of multiplayer. I mean, it didn't really work out for Bioshock 2 or Dead Space 2. Please tell me the inclusion of multiplayer isn't going to water down the single-player experience, as that's what I, and I'm sure other fans of Metro, love the game for.
One of the reasons why we've focused on single-player, both when we showed it at E3 last year and this year, is we really want to reassure those fans of the original. We understand why they loved the first game. I understand their concerns, but the addition of multiplayer is in no way to the detriment of single player. It's a different team with a very different skill set working on it. We have exactly the same resource applied to the single player this time around as we did last time, so they can expect, you know, hopefully another memorable single player campaign.
Awesome, thanks Huw. After seeing the footage and speaking to you, I'm definitely still very excited for Metro Last Light, even though it's been pushed back into next year. Let's hope all that 2012 nonsense is indeed nonsense, because I'm going to be severely pissed off if I never get to play this story of a Russian apocalypse because of a real apocalypse. Well, actually, I'll probably have bigger worries on my mind, like staying alive and stuff, but I'll still be slightly miffed about it, I reckon.